Hi, and welcome to the 11th and final session of our Coolselector deep dive. My name is Morten, and what better way of ending this session list than to talk about expansion valves. Now, in our previous sessions, we have talked about valves under very different operating conditions, compressible flow, under choking conditions, and now we're going to talk about expansion valves. And those are a special kind of valves where liquid enters the valve and two-phase come out on the outlet. It's actually quite difficult to describe these valves simply because the flow patterns are so difficult inside the valve. So what we do at Danfoss is that we approach the one expansion valve with three valves, and I'll just show you how that goes. We start out by looking at the basic valve equation. This is the equation we use for both compressible and incompressible flow, and the net expansion factor just has a value 1 for incompressible and something different for compressible flow. So, as I said, we approach the one expansion valve by having three valves. And let's call this valve 1, 2, 3. So for these three valves, we start at the inlet. We go in between valve 1 and 2, call this point 1. Between valves 2 and 3, point 2. And then we have the outlet. So now we write down the valve equation for each of those three valves. So, have mass flow, KV value for the first valve. So for the first valve, we have the first KV value, we have the unit conversion constant, we have the net expansion factor, we have the difference between the inlet pressure and the pressure 1, and the inlet density. For the second valve, we have the KV value. For the second valve, we have the constant net expansion factor. Now, then we have a factor called epsilon, and I'll return to this. Then we have the pressure difference and the density at the inlet. And now pretty much you know how this will go. For the outlet valve, we just have the KV value, constant net expansion factor, pressure difference, and the density at 0.2 at the inlet of this valve. Now, before continuing, we just have a short look at this epsilon factor. This epsilon factor is a function of the subcooling. And I'll get back to how that works. But instead of having one equation, we now have three equations, and we need to be able to solve this equation set. The mass flow we know, because it's the same through all valves, and it's normally given. The KV values we know, this constant we know, the net expansion factor. As we are approaching real situations, we normally just put that to 1. We have the epsilon, I'll continue to that later on. And then we have inlet pressure, which is known, outlet pressure, which is known, and then we have the densities and the pressures in between. So what this makes is actually a closed equation set. It's possible to solve iteratively. Now, the reason we correct this equation set with the subcooling is that if you start with a very low subcooling for the expansion valve, you start out by immediately expanding into the two-phase area. On the other hand, if you have a very large subcooling, you can actually end up in a situation where you're just expanding out in the liquid area all the time. So, this epsilon has a value of 1 for very large subcooling, and it has a value less than 1 for very low subcooling. So what this will do is that we will limit the mass flow on valve number 2 when you have a small subcooling, and if you have a large subcooling, you actually end up in an equation set that is the same as the one equation up here for incompressible flow. Now, when you look at these equations, normally the pressure drop distribution is so that about 0 to 5% is on the first, the inlet valve. Then you have from 70 to 95% on the valve number two, the main valve. And on the outlet, you have in the area of 5 to 30% of the pressure drop. So that is approximately the distribution. So in some cases, you can do without the inlet. The middle valve here is very important, and also the outlet is very important. And with this, we finish our session list of Coolselector deep dive. We hope you have enjoyed watching this as much as we have enjoyed creating this. In any case, thank you for watching.